By the end of 2020, the world eagerly awaited a solution from the scientific community as COVID-19 continued to mutate into more contagious variants as it circulated around the globe again and again. Now, with multiple vaccines distributed worldwide, it is becoming worryingly clear that many do not have the correct information about what a vaccine even is, let alone how they work. Which could be the reason why there is so much conspiracy and fear stigmatized to the very word vaccine. This is Dynamic Science. Time to grab your textbooks because Vaccines 101 is about to begin. Smallpox, once the most devastating illness ever suffered by humankind, killing some 300 million people worldwide in the 20th century, now only found in the darker pages of the history books, thanks to a doctor from the UK, Edward Jenner. He observed that milkmaids who had previously had cowpox did not catch smallpox. Curious by this observation, he had an idea. Since the symptoms of cowpox were not very severe, he injected a sample of children with the dead or weakened cowpox virus he called variola vaccina to see what transpired. He discovered that these children somehow became protected from the deadly variola virus that causes smallpox, thus creating the first ever vaccine and establishing the foundation of immunology. Every day you encounter germs such as bacteria and viruses, and the immune response is how your body defends itself. So you're not always sick from these constant attacks. To understand how vaccines work, we need to dive a little deeper into the workings of this immune response. When an antigen enters the body, one of the first things the immune system will do is send white blood cells to surround the invader, preventing more harm. Next, the adaptive immunity process kicks in. B cells and T cells are recruited to fight the invaders and produce special proteins called antibodies, which lock onto and destroy the antigen. All the while, special memory cells are recording the type of invader it has encountered. So, if the same germ or virus wants to wage war on the body once again, it has a stock of antibodies already prepared to identify and attack. Therefore, the immune system is able to kill it before it can severely infect the body. It is right here, the immune response of the memory cells, that vaccines take advantage of. A dead or severely weakened virus is used to trick our bodies into thinking we have the disease. Not enough to overpower the immune system, but just enough to trigger our adaptive immune response and create antibodies that protect you against future infection. So, not only healthy populations are able to be protected without having to contract the pathogen, but those with weaker immune systems, such as babies, older citizens, or those with an illness that reduces their immune system's functionality, are also able to be protected. Since the days of Edward Jenner, various types of vaccines have been created. Live attenuated vaccines, which are weak, tamer pathogens of the same virus. Vaccines for tuberculosis, polio, and the Ebola virus utilize this method. Inactive vaccines, which are made from dead pathogens for the more severe microbes. Influenza, hepatitis A, and rabies vaccines are made by this method. Even though the inactivation and weaker methods ensure that these microbes do not develop in full, they are still risky for people with very weak immune systems. Therefore, new methods were discovered for a safer application. Subunit vaccines. Only the antigen fragment of the pathogen, without any of the other dangerous molecules, is used in this method. So, when injected, the immune system still sees it as an intruder and responds accordingly. Hepatitis B, HPV, and meningococcal B are some diseases that are controlled with this type of vaccine. RNA vaccines. As the name says it all, this vaccine uses the RNA molecule of the microbe to trigger the adaptive immunity. Although these types of vaccines were still under development before COVID, the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines are all made using this method. Just like any other medication you put into your body, there are risks. However, regarding vaccines, you will find that the benefits will always outweigh these risks, even more so than many common medications. Let us take a look at the primary risk associated with the COVID-19 vaccine, the potential for blood clots. Statistically, the rate of blood clots in the AstraZeneca vaccine is roughly 1 in every 250,000 people, which, when put up against, say, contraception options such as the pill, the patch, and the ring, is actually highly desirable, with the risk of getting a blood clot being between 5 and 12 in every 10,000 people. Or for that matter, up against coronavirus itself, with more than 1 in 6 people being hospitalized for COVID-19 developing a blood clot. And yes, in some even rarer cases, vaccines may have adverse effects on a patient for seemingly unknown reasons. However, this is almost always due to other underlying medical conditions, which is why it is always advised for you to speak to your GP first. To put it bluntly, vaccines work. It has been proven over and over again. They are one of the most successful and effective ways to prevent disease, saving up to 3 million lives each year. However, as we have not faced such a global threat in quite some time, it seems many have forgotten how vital vaccines have been to the success of our species. Reasonable estimates suggest that if Edward Jenner's curiosity never came to fruition, between 1980 and 2018 alone, up to 200 million lives would have been lost to smallpox. And if you multiply this by the lives lost due to no vaccines for polio, tetanus, SARS, the flu, hepatitis, Ebola, rubella, measles, whooping cough, pneumococcal disease, rotavirus, and mumps, just to name a few, it is safe to say one would not want to even imagine a world without vaccines. Enjoying the content? Then shout us a coffee. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.